Sanibonani, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Nakanjani Sibiya. People are always curious whenever I tell them that my name is Nakanjani. They always want to know as to why my father, in his wisdom or lack of wisdom, named me Nakanjani. And I'm always reluctant to tell them. But tonight I'm going to tell you that I'm not going to tell you why my father named me Nakanjani, because honestly, I believe it's not, I believe that it's none of your business why my father called me Nakanjani. Some people call me a hunk. And when they started calling me a hunk, I was very excited. Until somebody who, it was by coincidence that he was my relative, but he was brave enough to tell me that I shouldn't be over the moon about that, because he said Hank is an acronym, is a Zulu acronym, which stands for How Upetelani Nakanjani Kangaka. So I think I stick to what I'm supposed to say this evening. I'm going to read about 20 poems with the sole intention of boring you. And I will start with a poem just to test the waters as to how bored you will be. The poem that I'm going to read, or maybe let me explain first that I have a mind and I prefer to use it for thinking. So I don't use my mind for memorizing and committing lines to memory. So the poem that I am going to read you, well, there's some history or some background to the poem that have fortunately been published. Most of them were written when I was very young. The one that I'm going to read was, I wrote it when I was 16 years old, which was about some 10 years ago. The title of the poem is Nakanjani. Loosely translated, it may mean it's about a person who is confirming and emphasizing that they are going to wait for somebody, no matter how many years it takes for that person to come back. But then it has some romantic feel to it. Although when I wrote it, I was too young to have a girlfriend, but I could imagine how people who are in love have some emotions and feelings. So the title is Nakanjani. Ngisho ngedlula iminyaka ngeminyaka, uma nje uyogcina utshuzile, wachubusha kulawo magagasi, wahlambela kulolu gu, wawelela kulezi zihlabathi esengatshalwa ngabethela kuzo. Nakanjani ngobe ngikulindile, ngiyokuhayela leyo nkondlo engayihayi ukude, wasondela. engayihayi useduze wanamathela ngiyoculela le yangoma engiyicule kuthangi engiyicule izolo usengapha sisendawonye. Another poem that I'm going to read has some history as well, particularly with regard to how writings in indigenous languages have been perceived. There's always been a perception that Zulu writers, in particular, only write stuff that is relevant for school-going kids. There's always been a perception, even now, that in the past there was nothing much that it was said by authors who chose to write in indigenous languages in the context of the political scenario and the political issues that were supposed to be addressed by authors in the past. I will read a poem that I alluded to the fact that people of different races were not allowed to fall in love in the past. So I imagined myself falling in love with a very beautiful white person, but then the circumstances would not allow us to enjoy our love and even maybe have beautiful kids. So I decided to write a poem entitled while you try to think about what the title of the poem is, I will page through. Yeah, this is what happens when you have written very few poems and they are published in an anthology that contains so many poems. And it's even worse if you are in front of an audience that does not sympathize with your failure to locate the relevant pages. The title of the poem is Gasinaqashuka Lesisibopho. Bathi gasinaqhabi ndawonye, bathi gasinatshakaduli ndawonye, bathi gasinaquli ndawonye, singaphuzi ndawonye, singakhothani, bathi gasinantwezi ndawonye, bathi gasinaqhwakeli gatsheni linye, bathi gasingaqoshi ntongomanye linye, singaquli ngaphimbo linye, singaxhobani, bathi gasingalaleli mculo munye, bathi singaxhengenyeki ndawonye, bathi gasingabukisani bohle bamvelo, singakhi izigodlo emoyeni, singaxhakani, bayangiqhweba, bayangimemeza, bayasinqaphela, bayasichapha. Gabana kuyipholisa le ntokomalo, gabana kuyibhidliza le nqaba, gabana kucisha lo mlilo, nalesi sibopho ngeke basiqashule. Sizotshakadula ndawonye, sizoqula ndawonye, sizotelebela ndawonye, sixhobane, sigaxane, sizocula ngomanye, sikhabe ndawonye, bazongiqhweba ngingezi, bangimemeze, ngingasabeli. Ezandleni bakithi. And when I grew older, I wrote a poem entitled Lamagagasi. Ngike ngisondele lapha, ngike ngiguqe lapha, amehlo ngiwaphonse laphayana, qede ngikubone ususondela, usondela ngesivinini sonyazi, bese zikhangeza ke lezi zandla, bese ziqhweba ke lezi zingalo, zomele leyo mfudumalo ethokomele, zilambele leyo ngcebe futhi eduduzayo, eziyizwe enyakenye nanyaka omunye, eziyigone kuthangi nayizolo, usengapha sisendawonye. Lapho ususondele, lapho sengisondele, sezilindele ukukuwola lezi zingalo, sesilindele ukugona lesi sifuba, ayadloba futhi lamagagasi, akhula abe zingelengele zezintaba, akugubuzele embali yami, umfanekiso obusugqame phambi kwami, upitshizeke, ushabalale, ngisale ngikhongozele ubala, ngisale ngigone ubala, ngiqoloza la magagasi akugwinyile. After growing older, I grew very old. And was aware of the sentiments that are shared by a very large portion of our population. A poem that I'm going to read alludes to the fact that politicians yes, politicians. In most cases, come to us with parcels and promises if and when it's time for voting. But then, when we have voted for them, for some reasons, they seem to forget about us. Until the next voting time. The title of the poem is Ngiyanikhumbula, which may loosely translate as I'm reminded of you. Ngiyanikhumbula zingane zakwethu, ngiyabukhumbula ubuso benu obumamathekayo, ngiyazikhumbula izingalo zenu ezivulekile, nisigona, nisinkonkoshela ngefudumalo, nisincenga. Ngiyazikhumbula izandla zenu ezifudumele, nisixhawula. Ngiyakhumbula amazwi amtodi njengoju, nisigixabeza izishuqulwana zamaphasela okudla, nisethembisa. Ngiyanikhumbula zingane zakwethu, ngiyanikhumbula nehla nenyuka ningalali, ningimisa ezibambanweni zemigwaqo. Ngiyanikhumbula nikhihliza amagwebu, nithi elami ivoti lizongwelisa ngelibanzi. Ngiyazikhumbula izaho zokunqoba, nigiya, nimpongoloza, niqukulana, nibongelana, nihaleliselana, nithi elami ivoti liniwelise ngelibanzi. Ngiyanikhumbula zingane zakwethu, nginikhumbula lapho ngibambe umuqa, ngishiswa ilanga, ngizanyuliswa indlala, ngiyogwazela indlu enathi nizongakhela yona, esengayilinda iminyaka ngeminyaka. Ngiyanikhumbula lapho umZulu ebuya ephethe umngenandlini, ebabaza usizo lwemali yeqolo, efunga igomela ngokushaya umphehlu ukuze lo mbele unganqamuki. Ngiyikhumbula lapho indodakazi ebuya ekhehla isililo, ethi ithenda aseyifune iminyaka, kuthiwe ngeke ayinuke uma singahlalanga phansi isikethi. Ngiyanikhumbula zingane zakwethu, ngilikhumbula lapho nidlula nishubeka ngezinkulukazi ezibelethe amasondo, ningifuqa ngothuli lomgwaqo, ningasami njengaqala, ningibingelele. Ngiyanikhumbula zingane zakwethu, ngilikhumbula nsuku zonke lapho ukushona kwelanga ngalinye kungikhumbuza lezo zithembiso enanizicela, uxolo enanizicula, ningilolozela nicela ivoti. Ngiyanikhumbula zingane zakwethu, nginikhunjuzwa ukushubeka kwezinsuku ezisondeza ukubuya kwenu futhi nezishuqulwana namaphaselana, nizoncenga, nizothembisa. I'm left with about 15 poems now. And the next poem I'm not going to read it because it's in English. The title of the poem is Love Bites. Here I sit again, alone, lonely, my hands reaching out in vain for a love that bites.